Welcome, students, to another Warframe Stigma special. You really shouldn't watch this video. Some of you are new to Warframe, and others are very new, as in, you just started today. And you might not know how to do shit worth a damn. So today, I'm going to teach you how to get good weapons. The wrong way. I advise you finish the video before you follow any instructions. You don't want to fall right into a trap, would you? This video is cursed. Oh, don't worry. You can trust me. I'm invested in your good fortune. Please, there is still time to escape. Anyway, let's talk about modular weapons. They are weapons that you can build using various parts that you also have to build. But the plus side is that they only take an hour to build. And you can get the parts from weapon vendors from open world hubs. This should be simple enough. How hard could it be? Let's go to Cetus to build a Zaw. Just run like 3 bounties and hit your standing limit, and then go to Hawk's Anvil. By the way, I've more than done my fair share of grinding for this place, so I already have access to everything. But I will be roleplaying as a noob, so pretend that I don't have jack shit to my name. And let's do this. Wow, look at these Zaw parts. I really like the Saw looking one. Saw Zaw. Okay, let's look at the menu and make a note of the resources I'll need. Okay, let's see. This good luck charm requires this and that. And then the stick takes grok drool, fish oil, and wait a minute, fish oil? Hawk, does fish oil actually make this thing more deadly? Oh yes, Suda. I've seen its effects firsthand. It killed my third wife. And what happened to the other two? Anyway, long ago the third wife and I ran out of the normal stuff, so we tried to use fish oil as an alternative. And so, 9 months later, she died. Ugh, can you please stop telling the story of my conception? You shut your mouth, Pitlick! So wait, your third wife died in childbirth? Mm-hmm. And you blame the fish oil? Mm-hmm. I don't get paid enough to make these videos. Alright, moving on. Cetus Wisp, Tuna, Chaos Emerald, and Metal. Okay, got it. Now we need to get all the required materials. But I think we'll need more standing for this. So let's go do another bounty. With Twilight Sparkle. Now that we have the required standing, let's get the parts we... Wait a minute. The Chaos Emerald requires me to be rank 2 with these mofos? Why would you let me buy something that requires rank 2 to make, DE? What the fuck? Alright, fine, fine, fine. I'll get the less cool looking one. Wait, isn't nighttime already? God, I've been wasting too much time. Alright, time to find the resources we need. With the tools and blueprints in hand, let's do some fish- WHY DOES THE KUT-KUT ONLY SPAWN IN THE DAY- Alright, let's do this shit again. Finally! Now after getting 5 of those, let's go do some mining. We're gonna go into the underground caves because they have a higher vein density than the surface. We don't need the blue veins, but we're gonna speedrun them so they don't get detected by our mining tool. Alright, ready, get set, go! Why are they infested here? Okay, that looks about right. After fishing, mining, grabbing the other resources off screen, and cutting the fish, we can finally move on to- Wait a minute. It takes 1,000 credits to build a portion of these shits, which means that... So 6 times 1,000 plus another 1,000, and the parts cost that much, and that would total out to 22,000 credits. We need to get 22K credits. Okay, you'll want to do that 3 more times with the mission credit reward on top of the mag parts we can sell for about 3.5K each. That should total about 22K. Which is what I would have said if you even got as far as Phobos in the first place. But no, some of y'all just started. So instead, we're gonna do some excavation. Because endless missions do reward rotations in a format of AABC, and the credit reward drops on rotation A, we'll be defending 2 excavators and then dipping. We will need to do around 4 or so runs to get the credits we need. Now, skipping ahead a bit, we can finally build the Zaw parts for an hour.
Ordis is sorry.
Shut the fuck up, Ordis! Okay, it's been an hour. Now we just need to go back to Hawk and assemble our Zaw. Now, let's look at our new toy. Yeah, it looks kinda goofy, but it works like a charm. I mean, look, even with a very basic build, it's doing the work against level 40 enemies. And it's not even gilded either. What is gilding, you ask? Well, you see, there's only so much you can do with a modular weapon in its basic state. Not only does gilding boost the stats a bit, you're also able to customize its appearance. But keep in mind, whether it be Zaws or kit guns, you must be rank 3 with the associated syndicate to do any gilding. And the process is gonna cost you. Oh, and I forgot to mention, when you gild modular weapons, you get to name them. Now that's a loadout, but I think we can crank up the stats just a bit more. And on top of that, I think I'm going to use my veteran privileges to customize a bit. First, we have
Russian roulette with a cum gun.
And then we have a Glock that can shoot big energy waves at enemies, and this pasta stick. This is the arsenal that will carry you to the end of the game. This is a terrible idea. Now let's see it in action. Why did I do this?
Welcome to the Cum Zone.
Oh shit, I forgot to use the other weapons. Okay, I will admit that mistakes were made. I've made many a mistake in my life. But this video is not one of them. Pedelec. 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 Fuck. Pedelec. 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 How do I say it? You shut your mouth, Pedelec! Pedelec. Pedelec. Okay, fuck it. One more for the road. You shut your mouth, Pedelec!